What up? Today, I'm going to talk about how to get everything that you want in life. I mean, literally everything. No bueno. I think I said that right. What is up, my fellow goal-getter? Welcome back to another video. If this is your first time here, hit the subscribe button and tap the bell notification so you don't miss anything if you want to learn how to dominate life. We're getting started right now. All right, I don't know if you knew this or not. You may have, you may not, but what we do mostly throughout the day is ask and answer questions to ourselves and to others. We're constantly asking ourselves questions and answering those questions. So the key to living a more fulfilled life, a quality life, is to ask more quality questions, because questions direct us. Whenever we ask a question or hear a question, whenever our brain hears a question, it immediately searches for the answer. So what questions are you habitually asking yourself that you probably consciously aren't even aware of, that they just happen? You know, so start being more consciously aware of that and raising the quality of those questions. And there's a reason for that, because a question directs our focus, and what we focus on determines how we feel and how we make our decisions and how we perceive reality, all that stuff. So questions are powerful, and we have to raise the quality of those questions. So instead of saying, why me? Or why does this always happen to me? Or why am I failing at this? Why can't I get this right? You know, those questions right there that a lot of us often say in our heads, unconsciously, we just do it habitually. You know, those are going to get you to focus on why you're not making it. And when you focus on why you're not making it, you're going to not make it. You get what I'm saying there? So, hey, you like how I asked you that question? It made you think and you had to answer that. Back to the point. Do you understand what I'm saying? Whenever you ask those questions, those are disempowering questions. Why does this always happen to me? Instead of change that to, how can I turn this around? What can I do to get closer to my goal? What's the next best step I can take? What's the best way to solve this problem? You see the difference in that? Like, when we focus on those types of questions, that's empowering. That gets us to actually get through to the goal. That's the key. Change the habitual questions and you will change the habitual results. We got to consciously change those, though, because those happen a lot of times. We're not even thinking about them. And as soon as we catch ourselves asking them, it's okay. Just stop it right then and there. If stop mid-sentence in your brain when you're thinking it, or if you finish it, just replace it right away. Immediately, as soon as you do, replace it right away and ask the empowering questions and make it a habitual pattern to ask these empowering questions. All right, so here's the nugget of the video. If you remember anything, this is it right here. This is powerful. I'm getting ready to share something so, so powerful. So the key is to be able to ask yourself these empowering questions in the moments of crisis and adversity in our lives. That's a critical, critical, critical skill to develop, because we're gonna face adversity, we're gonna face these crisis moments. And in these moments, what shapes our destiny is the questions that we ask ourselves. So let me give you a good example. When I was in prison the first time, when I did 4 years flat, and I was in the hole, which the hole is the prison inside of the prison. There's no human interaction, hardly any at all. If you do get that, you get, you know, your three crappy meals a day, and you get three showers a week, and you're just in a dark, dim, dirty place that makes you feel, it sucks, all right? A few weeks into it, I was down there for 2 months, and a couple weeks into that, I get called back to the captain's office. They bring me out in shackles on my feet and handcuffs on, back to the captain's office. And I'm thinking at the time, someone's told on me, whatever, you know, I'm 21 at the time, like, dude, you know, F the world, right? That's where my mindset was at the time. And I get back there and the captain says, how long you been locked up, Mr. Babcock? And I'm like, 2 years, you know, what's up, man? I ain't got nothing to say. Take me back to the cell. He's like, Mr. Babcock, we got a call over the weekend, and your mom informed us that your sister passed away from a heroin overdose. And, I didn't know how to respond to that. You know, like, that was the last thing I was expecting, that my sister died, and then I'm never going to see her again. I'm down in this shithole, and I got to deal with that. And so I asked him to put me back in a cell by myself. And for the next 3 days, I cried my heart out and was just, it was a horrible, horrible, horrible time. And on the third day, you know, I got up though and I asked myself, you know, I'm still here for a reason. I don't know what to do. What is the next thing that I need to do to improve my life? What's the next thing that I need to do to feel happy? I asked myself this with intensity and being all serious about it. And I kept asking myself that. And obviously I was trapped in an 8x10 cell. I can take 3 steps this way and 3 steps the next. There wasn't much of anything I could do, but what I ended up doing, the answers that I figured out from asking these questions, I started creating a daily habit. I would clean up my cell after every day after the food would come around in the morning. I would clean up my cell and I'd take a rag, you know, our towel. We had 2 bathing towels, you know, to dry off with on our showers. I took one of them, ripped it up into a bunch of mini rags, and I take one and scrub the wall with it, another one and scrub the sink, another one and scrub my toilet. Then I get down on my knees and sweep the concrete floor with my bare hands, gather up all the dust bunnies, and I take some toilet paper, get it damp, pick up the dust bunnies, and flush it down the toilet. Afterwards, I would take my last rag, get it nice and soapy, and wring it all on the ground, and then I'd scrub the floor. And that made me feel good afterwards because I was living in a clean environment and I did something, I accomplished something that day. And then after that, I'd work out for a couple hours until the next food came around. I feel good because I was releasing endorphins, natural endorphins in my body, and I was taking care of my health and I had something to do. I wasn't just stuck in my head sitting in a cell, you know? And then I'd read. I'm not a Bible thumper or a real religious person, but I am spiritual, and we didn't have anything to read down there, so I was reading the Bible at the time, and these scriptures helped uplift me. You know, what I'm getting at is I asked myself in a moments of crisis at one of my lowest points in my life, I asked myself, what's the next thing I can do to better improve my life? What's the next thing I can do to feel happy? And these empowered me to take that action. So ask yourself those empowering questions, especially in moments of crisis. And I want to ask you a question real quick. Have you downloaded my free goal getter cheat sheet yet? If not, no worries, but I want you to have this. This is the process that I developed over the last few years that has empowered me to take my life from being a drug addict and spending over 5 years of my life in prison to completely transforming it and becoming a responsible father and a successful entrepreneur. So I want you to go ahead and download that. You could do it right now by clicking right here. And if you know anybody that could benefit from hearing this message, please share it with them, because you never know what the right message for the right person at the right time, what that could do for them. So I appreciate you greatly. Keep on crushing those goals. Keep on dominating life. If you haven't hit subscribe yet, hit subscribe. Tap the bell notifications. That would make me really happy if you did that. And I will see you on the next video, my friend. Keep dominating.